स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल रीड आर्टिकल राइटिंग। व्हाट इज आर्टिकल? एन आर्टिकल प्रेजेंट्स इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन अ वैरायटी ऑफ थीम्स इन अ लॉन्ग एंड सस्टेंड पीस ऑफ राइटिंग। It involves a high degree of creativity, a wide vocabulary, and a thorough knowledge of the subject. Features of an article. It is written in third person. Language should be objective and to the point. A heading and a byline must be provided, appropriate to the subject and according to the question. It should normally consist of three parts: introduction, body, conclusion. Now, students, as I have told you that format of the article, first number is title, heading. Heading, eye-catching heading we have to give. Byline, byline means here, by whom the article is written we must write down. Body we have to give 3-4 paragraphs, like introduction, the opening paragraph, what the article is, catch attention, arouse interest of the readers, define the appropriate way, clear and precise language. We must give purpose of writing, plan before you write. Okay, use fact and so-called effect relationship. Give examples to support your views. Present arguments in a coherent, logical and convincing way. Create comparison and contrast. Compare and justify why your views are better. And last point, I have given conclusion. Conclusion: summing up, consolidation of ideas, offering suggestions, measures to improve the situation, personal observation and predictions. Following points should be kept in mind while writing article: appropriate vocabulary and grammar, unity, coherence, using the given information, research, quotations. Now, format of an article. I've written here question. Look at the question. Question I have written: you are moved to see the future of the nation. Children picking up rags and roaming about streets, etc. Write an article with a suitable title in about 120 to 150 words. You are Nitin, Nikita. Now, as I have written here, that you all are looking, that first what I have written, title: India's future is in darkness. First I have written title. Catching title. We must write eye catching title. Now, second, I have said you that you must write byline. I told you it means that who is writing an article? Who is writing an article? First, I have told you heading. We have to give an appropriate heading. Eye-catching heading, okay? I have told you appropriate heading and eye-catching heading. And then I have told you that you must give appropriate title, like I have written here, India's future is in darkness. That kind of title we have to write, okay? And what is the reason behind this? The heading should encapsulate the central theme. The heading should encapsulate the central theme. Okay, whatever we are writing, it must be clear with the help of heading. And second, I have said you byline, by whom the article is written. We must mention by whom the article is written. And now, third is body. Body, and this is the introduction part. First part, we must write introduction. I have told you that we have to write articles in 3 or 4 passages. I have told you, you have to write article, you have to include 3 and 4 passage para, you have to include 3 or 4 para. And I have written in first para, we have to write a body, and this body include introduction part. Okay, now introduction, the opening paragraph, we have to give what is the purpose of writing. In this introduction, we have to give what is the purpose of writing. Students, as I have told you, first we have to write down title, heading. The title is a short summary of the subject to draw the reader's attention. Here climate, I have given you that byline, it gives the name of the person by whom the article is written. It may include the designation if the question asks for it to be written for a newspaper, or it may include the class in which the writer studies if it is for the school magazine. After that, I have given you third point, that body. And first part, body, I have told you, introduction we have to give. It should include thought-provoking lines so as to develop the reader's interest. It can be a quote, observation, question, etc. And now, after that, this is the also the part of introduction, body. Okay. Introduction. Now, after that, we have to come to this point. After introduction, we have to write, this is the also main body. Now, what we have to write in main body? These people roam about streets and bazaars, picking up dust bills and waste, worn out or torn and tattered clothes, and they don't hesitate to search for rags, even in bad smelling garbage or sewage or ease pools. They carry bags on their backs and store their fuels in them. Very often the individuals divide a city into zones, and each zone is allotted to a particular group by mutual consent. The instruction of one group into another zone is resented and even results into fight. Now this is the main body. It should underline aspects such as effects, merits, demerits, cause, etc. Now this is the main body. Okay, this is the main body. And now last, I have given you, you all are looking, that first I have written title, after that byline, after that a main body, and at last we have to write in third para, conclusion. Very often young men who take to rag picking are the ones who come from villages to cities in search of jobs, and take to rag picking out of the sheer helplessness and desperation. Now, conclusion. It is a summing up after comparing ideas, it presents the writer's viewpoint, comment, criticism or recommendation. You may also sum up your article with an appeal or warning, an appeal, request, okay, you may write. Conclusion means summing up, consolidation of ideas, offering suggestions, measure to improve the situation, personal observation, prediction, okay. You have to put these points in your mind. This part is conclusion. Okay, students, you must keep points, okay, in your mind. You should be kept in mind while writing article, like appropriate vocabulary and grammar, unity, coherence, using the given information, research, planning, quotations. I think you will be able to understand. Thank you. Have a nice day.